Good evening and welcome to St. Catherine's Parish Church, to Evensong and Benediction of the Most Holy Sacrament. Beloved, we have come together in the presence of Almighty God and of the whole company of heaven to offer unto him through our Lord Jesus Christ our worship and praise and thanksgiving, to make confession of our sins, to pray as well for others as for ourselves, that we may know more truly the greatness of God's love and show forth in our lives the fruits of his grace, and to ask on behalf of all men such things as their well-being doth require. Wherefore let us kneel in silence and remember God's presence with us now. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from thy ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against thy holy laws. We have left undone those things which we have ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And there is no help in us. But thou, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare thou them, O God, which confess their faults. Restore thou them that are penitent, according to thy promises declared unto mankind, in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of thy holy name. Amen. Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who desireth not the death of a sinner, but rather that he may turn from his wickedness and live, and have given power and commandment to his ministers, to declare and to pronounce to his people being penitent the absolution and remission of their sins, he pardon and absolve all them that truly repent and unfeignedly believe his holy gospel. Wherefore let us beseech him to grant us true repentance and his Holy Spirit, that those things may please him which we do at this present, and that the rest of our life hereafter may be pure and holy, so at the last we may come to his eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open thou our lips. O God, make speed to save us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. Have our office hymn 150, O blessed Creator of the Light. Thank you. psalm this evening is Psalm 119, verses 89 to 104.
Thank you. The first reading is from Ecclesiastes, chapters 11 and 12. Send out your bread upon the waters, and after many days you will get it back. Divide your means seven ways, or even eight, for you do not know what disaster might happen on earth. When clouds are full, they empty rain on the earth. Whether a tree falls to the south or to the north, in the place where the tree falls, there it will lie. Whoever observes the wind will not sow, and whoever regards the clouds will not reap. Just as you do not know how the breath comes to the bones in the mother's womb, so you do not know the work of God, who makes everything. In the morning, sow your seed, and at evening, do not let your hands be idle, for you do not know which will prosper, this or that, or whether both alike will be good. Light is sweet, and it is pleasant for the eyes to see the sun. Even those who live for many years shall rejoice in them all. Yet let them remember that the days of darkness will be many. All that comes is vanity. Rejoice, young man, while you are young, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Follow the inclination of your heart and the desire of your eyes, but know that all these things God will bring you into judgment. Banish anxiety from your mind and put away pain from your body. For youth and the dawn of life are vanity. Remember your Creator in the days of your youth, before the days of trouble come, and the years draw near when you will say, I have no pleasure in them. Before the sun and the light and the moon and the stars are darkened, and the clouds return with the rain. On the day when the guards of the house tremble, and the strong men are bent, and the woman who grinds cease working because they are few, and those who look through the windows seem dimly. When the doors on the street are shut, and the sound of the grinding is low, and one rises up at the sound of a bird, and all the daughters of song are brought low. When one is afraid of heights, and terrors are in the road, the almond tree blossoms, the grasshopper drags herself along, and desires fail, because all must go to their eternal home. And the mourners will go about the streets before the silver cord is snapped and the golden bowl is broken and the pitcher is broken at the fountain and the wheel is broken at the cistern and the dust returns to the earth as it was and the breath returns to God who gave it. Vanity of vanities, says the teacher, all is vanity. Besides being wise, the teacher also taught the people knowledge, weighing and studying the arranging many proverbs. The teacher sought to find pleasing words, and he wrote words of truth plainly. The sayings of the wise are like goads, and like nails firmly fixed are the collected sayings that are given by one shepherd. Of anything beyond these, my child, beware. Of making many books there is no end, and much study is a weariness of the flesh. The end of the matter, all has been heard. Fear God and keep his commandments, for that is the whole duty of everyone. For God will bring every deed into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil. Here endeth the first reading.
Thank you. The second reading is taken from Isaiah, chapter 55, verses 1 to 11. Let everyone who thirsts come to the waters, and you that have no money, come, buy, and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money, without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen, so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than yours, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and succeed in the thing for which I sent it. Here ends the second lesson.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. O Lord, show thy mercy upon us. O Lord, save the queen. Endue thy ministers with righteousness. O Lord, save thy people. Give peace in our time, O Lord. O God, make clean our hearts within us. Blessed Lord, who caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, help us so to hear them, to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, through patience and the comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and forever hold fast the hope of everlasting life, which you have given us in our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that both our hearts may be said to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of our enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness through the merits of Jesus Christ our Saviour. Lighten our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of thy only Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
We have our hymn, As Now the Sun's Declining Rays. Hymn number 242.
May the words of my lips and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you, O God. Amen. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. I don't know if you've ever done this. On more than one occasion, I have come to the checkout of the supermarket, only to find that I have left my wallet at home and have no way to pay for my groceries. In case this has never happened to you, and Roz assures me that this is not something most people experience, what happens next is they leave all your groceries behind customer services, frozen and all, until you can return with your wallet. What does not happen, what has never happened to anyone, is that they let you buy it all for free. That would be a contradiction in terms. It would make no logical sense, nor would it be sound business sense. But that is what God is saying through the prophet Isaiah here. God is calling us to buy without money and without price. Of course, my illustration could be seen as a little crass. I could go home and find my wallet, and inside, a debit card allowing access to enough money to buy all the groceries that were defrosting behind customer services. No, to grasp the full force of Isaiah's message, we have to remember that there are many people, even in our own community, who do not have the money to fill a trolley when they need it. My problem started with a realization of forgetfulness at the checkout. Their problem starts at the supermarket door. No, imagine that someone beckons them in. Come, buy your groceries for free. Spend a moment imagining how that would feel. You that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. You see, Isaiah's call is to the thirsty and hungry, not to the merely peckish, but to people who long for what truly satisfies, as a starving person longs for the nourishment of bread. Do we recognize that we are thirsty and hungry, not for physical sustenance, but for what will satisfy our souls? We live in an age when there are lots of things competing for our attention. I don't know about you, but I find it hard to hold a conversation with someone if the telly is on. Do we live our lives like this, like someone entranced by the TV, no matter how bad the program is? Or are we like someone who is not quite into the program and have a feeling that something else must be on and could quite easily change channels? How do you feel about all the different things in life competing for your attention? Does life captivate you? Or do you feel there must be something more? You may know the feeling when you have bought something, and there's nothing wrong with it, but it doesn't bring you the joy that you thought it would. I'm not talking about sadness or disappointment, but that feeling of being a little lukewarm, that small sense of restlessness. Listen to that feeling. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? And listen to what Isaiah has to say, for he is bringing good news. The prophet is speaking to the Jewish people, suffering exile in Babylon. Isaiah's good news is that their nation will be great again. Foreigners will worship the God of Israel. How unexpected, how utterly different to their current situation, how different to the way they had come to see the idolatrous nations around them. Who'd have thought that they could all worship together? And then in verse 6, Isaiah has good news for all of us. If it wasn't enough that he got our attention by inviting us to buy without money, we are told that what will satisfy us is to seek someone who is near. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. If someone is near, why do we need to look for them? It makes no sense, unless his presence is not obvious to us, because we are so distracted. This, Isaiah proclaims, is what is deeply nourishing, to seek the God who is near. And if we seek God, if we call upon the Lord, if we return to the Lord, he will forgive even the wicked. In our own thoughts, we might expect God to reward the good and to punish the bad. We might imagine that God has weighing scales to see if our good outweighs our bad. But God's thoughts are not our thoughts, and his ways are not our ways. God will abundantly pardon. God's generosity, God's grace is unfathomable, but not without cost to himself, I must add. The abundant generosity of God is like being invited to buy food without money. It is so ridiculously generous, it makes no sense to us. But there's no getting away from the fact that it all boils down to this. My own experience has been that when we listen to God, when we truly seek God in contemplation, we will always keep coming back to his grace. And we have an opportunity for that this evening. I invite you, come, listen carefully, and as we sit in the presence of the God who is near, eat what is good. For the presence of God in the sacrament defies logical sense. But his thoughts are not our thoughts, and his ways are not our ways. Call upon Jesus. Feast yourselves on the steadfast love, on the abundant grace that defies logical sense. Feel this love coming back to you. If it helps, imagine Jesus sat opposite to you. What does he have to say? Amen.
We have our next hymn, Thee We Adore, O Hidden Saviour Thee, number 308.
Thank you.
God of love, Jesus gave us the commandment to love, to put everything and everyone, to love our neighbour in the same way and to the same degree that we care for ourselves. Today we come before you, offering you our hearts and our prayers for ourselves and for all those who are in need at this time. Let us pray for all religious leaders as they work to bring hope to a world which has been turned upside down and traumatized by the effects of the global pandemic. May their inspiration give us courage and strength that we may need at this time. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for all politicians and everyone involved in local and national governance, that they may exercise wisdom, understanding and thoughtfulness in order to bring about the greatest good for the greatest number of people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for us all as we try to control the spread of the coronavirus through whatever means are available to us. May we protect the vulnerable, care for the sick, and have compassion on those who experience frustrations of lockdown. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for families struggling to cope with difficulties which seem to have no straightforward answer. May they find peace and practical solutions which they need. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let us pray for everyone who has experienced job insecurity as a result of the coronavirus. May they experience peace of mind and find hope amid their uncertainty. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In a few moments of silence, as we kneel before this blessed sacrament, we offer our thoughts and our prayers and our lives to the God of grace, mercy, and peace. Lord God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we ask you to hear our prayers, and in your great love, help us to spread your love in our world. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thou gavest them bread from heaven. Let us pray.
O God, who in a wonderful sacrament has left unto us a memorial of thy passion, grant, we beseech thee, so to venerate the sacred mysteries of thy body and blood, that we may ever perceive within ourselves the fruit of redemption, who liveth and reigneth world without end. Amen. Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be
Blessed be a holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be a holy and immaculate.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be Saint Joseph.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Blessed be God.